In addition to sizing residue and getting the soil ready for planting, tillage also plays a key role in weed management. And with me today is Meaghan Anderson, a field agronomist with Iowa State University, to talk a little bit more about how those two things interact. So Meaghan, before we ran the tillage soil through this field, we had applied a decent layer of blue dye in order to help us understand a little bit more about how incorporation happens with the soil and herbicides. Give us your thoughts on what should an operator think about, a producer think about, in terms of the role of tillage and herbicide and weed management, how those work together.
Yeah, so one of the most important things when we apply residual herbicides, especially in the spring, is that we need to be thinking about getting that herbicide mixed in the soil somehow, and tillage is one option to do that. And then another thing that we often think about in the spring is, do we have weeds that are present in the field when we're first coming out there in the spring, and how are we gonna manage those? And tillage is an option to manage those as well as burn down herbicides.
That's great. So in front of us, Meaghan, we've got a 3-degree gang angle, which is a pretty a low aggressive setting for a VT tool. And I see a lot of blue on top of the soil surface still. What concerns you about that?
Yeah, so like I said, that herbicide mixing is really important when it comes to residual herbicides. And as you can see, most of, if this were a herbicide, most of it would have been left right here on the soil surface, so it would not have been thoroughly mixed into that profile. Now, for most herbicides, we don't require the herbicide to actually be mixed mechanically. It does need to get in the soil somehow, but we get a lot of rainfall here in the spring that can do that as well. But there are some herbicides where that mixing via mechanical incorporation is basically essential. And this just would not have done an adequate job, and we wouldn't have expected it to at that shallow angle.
So Meaghan, the spot we're in now in the field was tilled with a 5-degree gang angle with a vertical till tool. And when I look out here, there's a couple of things that stand out. First of all, I see less residue on the ground, right? Which tells me we're doing some level of additional mixing. And as I look at the blue dye that we put on the soil surface, I can still see some of it, but it appears less less intensive. What are your thoughts and how this would map out to herbicide management?
Yeah, so I think you can definitely see less of it on the soil surface, which is a good thing. I still wonder about how much of it is actually getting mixed, because mm-hmm. That's key.
Well, thanks, Meaghan. We've got one more treatment to look at, which is a 9-degree, really aggressive gang angle. So let's go take a look at that. When we dug below the soil surface, this looked like certainly the one that had the most shatter and incorporation. And we sort of see that. There's still some spots on the very top of the soil where it looks like maybe we flaked off some clods or things that weren't quite as closely incorporated. You know, I'd like to get your thoughts in general as a field agronomist, somebody that specializes in weeds. Is this a helpful way to help visualize and demonstrate the job quality we're doing to get herbicide hopefully incorporated into that surface?
Yeah, I think using this chalk was a really low cost and really low effort way for us to get a pretty good visual of how much we actually mixed in the soil. And I think given the fact that we can see nice differences, this would be a great tool for somebody to be able to use themselves.
Thanks, Meaghan. Just to help put a wrap on some of the concepts and things that we identified today, first and foremost, you know, the tillage tool that you use is going to be an option that's selected based on your overall management plans. VT tools, though, do offer a lot of adjustability, the ability to change the outcome based on how you set up that tool in the field. At the end of the day, though, the tool is only as good as how you set it up, so we encourage all of you to be thoughtful and choose the type of outcome that you're after based on how you configure your tillage tool.